You've brought a medical malpractice case against your doctor whom you believe caused you significant harm and injury. The defense refuses to acknowledge they did anything wrong. So now your case goes all the way to trial. During a break at trial, can you go ahead and talk to the court reporter, the court stenographer, to ask her how she thinks your case is going? You wanna know the answer? Come join me for a moment as I share with you some great information. Hi, I'm Gerry Oginski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. So now, you brought a lawsuit. Your case is going to trial because the defense refuses to negotiate. And now we need six members of the community to come to a decision about whether or not you are slightly more likely right than wrong that what you are claiming is true. During a break in your trial, you have the urge to go ahead and talk to the court reporter, the stenographer, whom you've seen almost every single day. She's there recording everything that's said during the course of trial. She's there to record the questions that are being asked and the answers that are being given. She's there to record the objections that are raised and the rulings that the judge makes. All of these things are being recorded in real time. Now, there's a break during the trial. The morning break, everybody goes out to the bathroom or to make calls, and now you want to go up and talk to the court reporter just to get her opinion. Hey, Ms. Court Reporter, I'm curious. What do you think about my case? I'm curious what you think about this witness. Can you, as the injured patient, go up and talk to this court reporter? Here's the reality. The reality is that you could. You could start chatting with the court reporter. You could have a conversation with the court reporter outside the presence of the jury during the course of a break. In all likelihood, the court reporter is not going to engage in a significant conversation with you. Even if she tells you her opinion about how she thinks the case is going, guess what? It doesn't have any bearing whatsoever on the outcome of your case. What she thinks is going on in your case, what she thinks about a particular piece of evidence, what she thinks about a witness's credibility, doesn't matter at all. You want to know why not? It's because she's not on the jury. It's because she's not the one who has to evaluate each witness's credibility. She's not going to be one who participates in jury deliberations. Even though she has been in court each and every day, even though she has participated in hundreds and hundreds of cases throughout her career and has heard everything you can possibly imagine, the reality is that asking her opinion is not going to help you in the slightest. You might gain a friend, you might gain a sympathetic ear, and you might feel that, hey, if she thinks that the case is going in your favor, you may feel buoyed by that. Buoyed, is that a great word? No, you may feel energized by her answer, and now you may think you're winning your case. But guess what? Going through a trial is literally an emotional roller coaster. During the course of trial, there will be days where you are on an emotional high, and other days when you are on an emotional low. And that's how it goes, because you will feel as if you are winning at certain times of the day, and other times your cross-examination for your witness is going terribly and you feel all the way down here. And that's how it goes. These gyrations are crazy. And so your emotions follow up and down throughout the entire day and throughout the entire trial. So simply by going ahead and engaging this court reporter in a conversation does not indicate what really is going to happen in your particular case. So although you have an urge and a desire to talk to her, sure, if you want to be friendly, you want to be nice, you can have a conversation. I guarantee you it won't be an extensive conversation because the court reporter has things to do and needs a break of her own in order to rest up so she can be prepared to record all the information, all the comments, and everything that's happening during the course of trial. So why do I even raise this? I raise this because during the course of trial, you won't be getting any feedback from anybody in the courtroom about how your case is going. At the end of each day, you'll be asking your attorney, so how do you think this witness did? How do you think the case is going? What do you think of the jury? And he'll give you his thoughts. But the ultimate reality is that nobody knows what's ultimately going to happen. Nobody can guarantee a result. And even though you're sitting in the courtroom each day and you're watching the jury and you're listening to the testimony, you don't really know what's going on in the jurors' minds. And even if you think you do, I'm telling you right now, it's not right. When I say not right, I mean it's not going to be accurate. Why? Because at the very beginning of your case, the judge tells the jury, listen, don't make up your mind during the course of the trial. Don't make up your mind after listening to parts of testimony. The jury will not have heard the law in your particular case. The only time they hear that is at the very end of your trial, after closing arguments have been made by each of the attorneys. Only then the judge locks the courtroom door, or has the court officer do it, to prevent anybody from coming in and interrupting him from telling the jury what the law is. And then for the next hour, The judge tells the jury exactly what the law is, and then he tells them what questions they have to answer in order to reach their verdict. Only after they consider the evidence, and only after they discuss all the issues amongst themselves, are they to go ahead and begin answering the questions to come to a conclusion about whether or not you are entitled to a verdict in your favor. So why do I share this information with you? I share it with you just to give you an insight and an understanding into what goes on in these medical malpractice cases here in New York. You know, I understand you're watching this video because you likely have questions or concerns about your own matter. Well, if your matter did happen here in New York and you're contemplating bringing a lawsuit but haven't done so yet because you still have questions that need to be answered, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. I can answer your legal questions. You know, I answer questions like yours every single day, and I'd love to chat with you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at gerry@oginski-law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Gerry Oginski. Have a fantastic day.